In this video, you will learn about the importance of testing. You will see some of the tests that you can perform while developing your workflows, and finally, how to test your workflow before deployment. Let's jump into it. Testing is an important phase of workflow development. By testing a workflow, you make sure that it behaves as expected when put into production and can detect issues as early as possible. A workflow should be tested before being put into deployment, every time that it gets updated, and every time that its environment changes, for example, after a new version of KNIME Analytics platform is released. There are various test types, for example, unit tests, application tests, model, stress, and integration tests. In this video, we will focus on unit tests, that is, testing single, small, independent parts of an application. The concept can be easily extended to other forms of testing as well. Unit tests are usually applied to a small part of your application. It is best practice to modularize your application in smaller, specialized segments to be able to test them separately. This is easy to do with integrated deployment. Ideally, your complex workflow is a modular application that orchestrates multiple workflow segments and shared components. Unit tests should be created for each of them. In this example, the workflow calls multiple workflow services and uses a few shared components to perform lexicon-based sentiment prediction. To perform a unit test of this first workflow service, create a so-called test flow, a separate workflow where you'll run one or multiple tests. First, call the unit that you want to test. In this case, configure the call workflow service to call the workflow segment. Pass it the test data. This data should resemble the unit's input data in production, but should be small enough to perform the test quickly. In our example, this data contains a few tweets. Then, you need the so-called golden output data. This data is the result that you expect that the unit you're testing should produce. Now you've got the actual results and the expected results, and you need to test whether they are the same. You can use the table different checker node to do that. The table different checker succeeds only if the two data tables are the same, that is, if the workflow that you are calling has produced the expected results. Alternatively, you can use the table different finder node. It is similar to the table different checker, but can return the differences between the output table and the golden output table. Create one test flow for each of the other segments and share components of the workflow application. The table different checker and finder nodes compare two tables precisely, both structure and values. Sometimes, however, you need just to ensure that the table structure is correct while allowing different values. A node that can do that is the table validator. It validates the structure of a table. For example, it can check whether the table contains the correct columns of the correct types, whether they have missing values, and whether the values are in the expected domain. Validating the table structure is useful in many applications, for example, in testing prediction workflows, where the extract predicted values change for different inputs, but you still need to make sure that the table structure is correct and that the values are in a certain range. Ideally, you need to create multiple tests and test flows to test different parts of your application and run all of them periodically to ensure that everything works as expected. This can be done manually, but this does not scale if there are too many test flows to run. Imagine a complex application with hundreds of segments or components, or if your application has to be updated very often, for example, a prediction service for rapidly changing data. One way to automate the process of testing is by making the test flow scalable as workflow services and calling them from an orchestration test workflow. Each unit test flow should return the status of the test, passed or not, and the details on errors. The orchestration test workflow calls all the unit tests, collects the results, and produces a report containing the results of each workflow. In this way, the single workflow lets you perform a comprehensive testing of all the modular parts of your application. Unit tests should be conducted on a single entity, a workflow segment performing a particular single function or a shared component. You can, however, have multiple unit tests for the same entity, testing with different inputs or in different conditions. Make sure to create test flows that output meaningful information to be able to easily spot what went wrong during the test. Test regularly, ideally every time that the workflow or its environment changes. In this video, you've learned about the importance of testing, you've learned about some different kind of tests that you can perform while developing your workflow, how to test your workflows before deploying them, and finally, you've seen how to automatically run multiple test flows and generating a testing report.